Come on, no whammies. No whammies. Looks like we're going. Okay, we're going. Nice. All right, all right. Okay, I had to lower the resolution for the video. Sorry, YouTube viewers later on. This video is once again at a lower quality because I couldn't get my settings to work. Streaming all this at its highest quality like I used to. But oh well. One day I shall get this all fixed and we will be triumphant. And we'll be able to see the videos at high quality again. Today I'm working on the cutscene for the intro again. And let me get this set up so we can have the just skip straight to the intro scene now. Skip everything else and just play the intro of the game. Where the hell is it? Oh, here. Skip to intro. You shouldn't crash anymore. All right. Ruined? What? Ruined again? No. Ah, goddamn. So it's not, it wasn't this, the quality settings then. Oh, this is so lame. Why does this always happen on Saturdays? This always happens on Saturdays, man. Maybe it's because everybody's using the internet today. Maybe a bunch of people moved in my neighborhood and everybody is live streaming in my neighborhood. And that's why none of us can get good upload rates for our cable modems. BS. So can you guys still hear me? It sucks. Everyone's watching Netflix. Could be that too. Could be just the upload rate. Or I mean the download rate is killing the upload rate. Somehow. Let me try resetting it once. Just the stream part. We might be back now. I don't know. Okay, so this is the only chance I get right here. Let me show the game a little bit, and I'll show you what I will be working on today. I'll be working on pixel art mostly. This is the cutscene that I'm working on. It's offline again. Yeah, so there's a story. This is the story told from Jib's perspective. Jib wakes up on Songbringer, has no memory of the past. And he's actually 5,000 years old at that point. But he has no memory of any of his past. He wakes up on Songbringer. And basically, I'm drawing a bunch of cutscenes. So this is going to be like an intro cutscene with lots of different visual scenes. So right now, I'm just showing this one zoom up here on the star because that's the only cutscene I've created so far. But this, all this text, basically every one of these lines will have a different image, and it'll be a lot slower. Actually, it won't be this fast, as it's just kind of ripping through all the text here. But yeah, that's what I'm working on right now. Okay. And one other thing. Hey, it looks like it's actually streaming right now. One other thing too, I've got this all pro too. I got this whole scene set up, so even if I can hold down a key and it starts saying hold the skip, see that in the top right, hold the skip, and then if I hold it down for a good second, then it skips the intro. So it seems like a nice pro way to do it. You know, you're not obscuring the screen or whatever with any text until the player starts pressing something, and then it's like good for accidents too, because it's not just going to skip the whole intro unless you actually hold it for a minute. All right, so I'm going to draw the next scene in that intro right now. I'm going to work on a planet scene of Xera, the planet they're going to be on, and this is going to be kind of at an angle and everything. Let me get this document set up. And once again, if the stream goes out today, saved? Nice, nice. If the stream goes in and out today, I'm just going to keep streaming and recording this and just upload it to YouTube for later. So anyways, I'm just going to forget the fact that the internet just died there a second ago. And we'll keep streaming as smoothly as possible. So I'm going to create a new document for this planet scene, And I want to throw the slightest bit of nebula in the background of this scene. So let me get some black going first. Start with some black inky sky. Maybe some slightly purple black. And yeah, let's get this thing saved, started raw. No, wait, sprites. We call this. This is Xera. All right, I'm gonna grab the Songbringer. Not that one. What? Hold on. I didn't click on that. Poster two. Oh. It's a bugging. Oh, did I send off that tweet? Oh, here, send the tweet. Send the tweet! There, the tweet has been sent. All right, so I want to get this document. Wait, I already got it open. Yeah, this has a cool background. Zilton, do we get a name stuff? Do we get a name stuff? Dude, just wait. Just wait. There's going to be your golden opportunity to name something at some point. I don't know if it's going to be today. But you know what? Never mind. Yes, there's got to be something you can name today. I'm sure there is. How about this nebula? What do you want to name this nebula? Dude, you get to name this nebula right now. What is the name of this nebula? Rocket Bunny, Lighter Thief, Giga. All right, Giga it is, dude, here. Boom, you just named something. Giga. Let's get some stars. Wait, we'll grab those from Bellatrix. What's up, PMC? What's up, Light of Thief? It's going great, man. So really, really good. I'm working on this cutscene. This is the cutscene for the beginning of the whole game. This is the intro. So this is a spoiler alert, kind of. If you don't want to ever see the plot for the game, even the first 5 minutes, you might not want to watch today's stream. This is the first 5 minutes of the game's story, basically. I forgot the L. What? What? I thought it was Giga. Or is it Gigya? Gigyal? Oh, there's it is all L. Sorry. Gosh, gotta name things right around here. What am I trying to do? Name stuff wrong? Okay, I'm gonna cheat and just grab all these stars. I'm gonna throw together kind of a mock-up quickly here of the planet Xera, the angle of the planet and everything. That should be below the nebula E thing. All right, okay, so the planet is going to be this giant circle. It's a circle planet. It's got circle-y stuff. Nigel? That's a lot like Rigel. All right. So let's do, wait, did I already get this layer started? No. It's gotta name stuff. You gotta name stuff or else you forget what the hell a layer is. Like, what is this layer? Is this some empty random layer? Yeah, it's totally empty and random. Let's get rid of it. Jeez. There are no empty random layers around here. All right, so this is gonna be the planet. do the weird color here, like a darkish purple once again. And this is about the angle right there. Why did that draw partially up transparent? If you're naming it Nigel, you have to name something adjacent Thornsberry. You always end up with, like, right? How do you get these empty layers? Where did these come from? Oh, there we go. Okay, so there. It's not going to be that color purple, but... The view counter isn't working, man. Dude, it's Twitch's fault. It's got to be Twitch's fault. It ain't my fault. No way. No how. All right, that's looking better. Now I want to do like a rim of light. All right, we'll start with the color of the star. Oh, also, I do want to get the background in here. I want to get the other planet in here first before I do. I'm thinking of doing like a rim of light here and the sun rising in the back. Yep, true story. Can't upload to YouTube. Right. All right, so we want to get this other image up, poster 2, and this is the planet that I want to put in the background of Hia 2. Hia. Whoops. Flip this over. Yeah. All right. So I'm putting together a quick mock-up image of what I want this this cutscene's image to look like. So I'm working fast here just to kind of get things roughly in place, and then I'll go in and do some detail. This is going to be a sun rising behind a planet, so you're just barely seeing some light on the planet. And then there's another planet in the background. I'm trying to think if I want this to be a lot bigger or not. YouTube. Do I want it bigger? I think so. That'd be ridiculous if this planet was that big, that close. It would not make any physical sense at all, but it would look sweet. Let's try one bigger, and then we'll see if it looks better that way. Right? This is ridiculous. This would never happen. Maybe it would. Shit. I don't know. What am I? Astrophysicist? Right? I guess this just could be a gigantic planet here in the background. And put it below the planet. Okay, so there's what it might look like with that in the background. Here's what it looked like. Oh yeah, see, little one looks stupid. Right, we'll start with something like this. Okay, let's get the light in here and the sunshine and everything. That's gonna really set this image off. Yeah. Uranus. The number of points they should get to be the number they guessed. Ooh, interesting. Right, so let's put the sun on this layer. Right, like. Would have to be over here. Or shit. Oh, I don't know if this light's gonna work. If the light's coming from this image right here has the light coming from down below. I gotta think about the light here. Right, so here's right, some light's coming in from that way. But I wanted the light to be just brimming over the like brimming over the top like this or like that kind of. So let's get rid of this planet to start with. It's not working yet. Let's do the light of the planet. Let's start with this, because this is the most important part. The other part is not that important. Right, so I like that hue for the star. This is the star Bellatrix. If anything, its light's gonna be bluish. That's weird. I didn't think I'd be doing blue light, but let's try it. Right, if the star is coming across the horizon, like about there, what just happened? Oh, right about there. Let's put it behind. Flip the back planet vertically. Yeah, maybe. Yeah, maybe just flipping it vertically would work. I'll try that. I'll try that last. I'll add in the planet last. Oh, dude. What am I using the mouse for still? Lord of mercy. Get the graphics tablet out. All right. I want to see a lot of light shining. Really bright. Let's do that. Let's get some Gaussian blur started. Probably gonna do this a bunch of times. Blue light, really? Is this really happening? This is crazy. Yeah, BC Warrior. So this one will do a little more blur. Yeah, like a lot of blur like that. Oh, wait, hold on, hold on. Hold on. Gotta make sure this is 16 bits per channel. This is gonna be a pretty blurry image. There's a lot of blurs. And 16 bits per channel really bumps up the quality there on the blur. I didn't really notice much difference between 16 and like the next one up myself. Yeah, see how much smoother that is? Whoa. Now we're cooking with fire or whatever we're cooking with. Okay, I'm gonna try even redoing this first blur with the higher quality. Filter, blur, Gaussian. I think it was 19. 19-ish. All right. Now we need a rim of light, which means I think I'm going to just duplicate the planet. Make it all this color. And then cut out a hole where the light's not supposed to be. Why isn't that working? Work, damn you. What? It's not working. Oh, you can't. Oh, what? This is so messed up. I really wanted to just erase it right there, but the image is too small. Okay, so I'll just make the image twice as big. Smash it up in the top right corner. Still not working. What the? Yeah, definitely gonna look for that lens flare. Zoc Games, what's up, Zoc Games? How's it going? I'm fumbling with my freaking eraser here. Can't figure out how to erase this. Oh, look, now all of a sudden it works. That was close. That's pretty good. I like that one. Hold on. And would that have worked if I had a regular size document? Maybe. Use the eclipse selector. Oh, ellipse. I thought you were making a joke about the eclipse selector. I'm like, I wish there was an eclipse selector. All right, lighter thief, see you, man. All right. I want to do another one. Accidental jokes are the best kind. That's a serendipitous joke, man. Serendipities, he's on our side today. Yeah, I like this where the light's a little more at that angle. I'm gonna do one more. Well, you did, man. Stardew Valley. Nice. Wow, 13 hours. All right, let's do it one more. Wow, what would this look be like at 1,000 pixels? That's kind of what I'm going for. Right there. Cool. All right, we got a little bit of glow. Let's get this thing like really lens flary and awesome now. Actually, it'd be cool to get a planet already in there too. I'm doing it. Don't care what anybody says. Oh, nice. You're doing your own thing? Right on, Zoc. Good for you. Oh, we went to Planet Tobor. Planet Tobor, savage. Well, that's pretty. Wow. Beautiful. Whoa. This is crazy. We're getting raided. We're getting raided hard. Super raid. What's up, raiders? Raiders of the stream? Raiders of the last stream. How about that? Ooh, there's a good example of some lens flare. Raiders of the last stream. Whoa, raiding the stream. There's some beautiful planets here. I just want to get some like Earth shots. Earth. Hey guys, help us. From what planet? Yeah, what planet do you all you Raiders reside on? Obviously, Uranus. Ooh, that's kind of a nice one right there of Earth. This is more what I was thinking. We got a nice shine going on there. Okay, let's do this. Planet, Earth, sunrise. We come from you come from the Shrek planet? Neptune's pretty cool too. Gotta love Neptune. You guys want to see the game I'm working on? Raiders, let me show you the game I'm working on. Let me show you. I'm gonna force you to see it. You gotta keep your eyes open the whole time, all right? Don't not look. We conquer in Dianar's name. Nice. This game is called Songbringer. It's like Zelda. You're this dude with the sword here. That's your little robot friend. His name's Jib. So when you fight enemies and stuff, Jib. goes and like scans bodies for items and stuff. But it's this very... Oh, this once again is the home area. Let's buy some cactuses. You never have too many cactuses. Never ever. I was like, I was binding it to the wrong button. Monkey on a bus! Oh, monkey on a bus, it has been quite a while. Yeah, it's very inspired by Sword and Sorcery. Definitely. The art style, at least. The game is inspired by Zelda 1. A lot of people these days don't even know Zelda 1. But it's my favorite Zelda. I like Zelda 1 so much because of its openness. I really felt that it was one of the most open-feeling Zeldas there ever was. After Zelda 1, they constantly started gating you in, and more and more you had to, get little puzzles done first before you, before you could leave the home area and stuff. I'm gonna turn into God mode and go into this dungeon here and show you some dungeons. So anyways, I really love Zelda 1 for that. Zelda 1 didn't force you to make choices. They gave you all the choices and just said, here you go. What do you want to do? Do you want to play level 1 first? Do you want to play level 3 first? At the very first screen, do you even want to get the sword? You don't even have to get the sword. Raid successful! Bam! Raid it! That was a really nice intro to your guys' raid. I really like that. It's just poop, 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 poop. Yeah. So anyways, I'm trying to create this game Songbringer. The real big difference between this and Zelda 1 is that this is procedurally generated. So when you start your game, you get, you pick 6 letters, and those 6 letters generates your, and that gives you a world seed. And that world seed is used to generate the same world no matter what. So if you're playing it on Windows, Mac, Linux, PlayStation, Xbox, whatever platforms this game comes out, I'd know for sure it's going to be on Steam this year. But anyways, maybe consoles too. Whatever platform you're playing on, you get the same world. Basically, if you enter the world seed Xanadu, which is my favorite world seed lately. If you enter that seed, you're always going to get the same world, so it's going to be great for speedrunners. You know, speedrunners can play the same world over and over. Or, if you want a completely different world, just enter some random seed and you get something weird. Do you still have the girl with the afro? Yes, she is one of the key characters in the game. She's going to be an NPC. And, I'll actually be working on her pretty soon. I was gonna have her as a playable character, but it makes a lot more sense that the second playable character would be Jib, the robot guy, which has disappeared again. Look at him, he's totally disappeared. Anyways, there's bosses too. Let me see if I can show you guys a boss before I get back to making some pixel art here. Here we go, there should be a boss in here. Yeah, here's one of the bosses. Throwing my ice top hat and my fire, I'm shooting it with the fire sword. So everything in this game, you can actually craft weapons. So for example, I started with this ghost sword, and I crafted it with fire and got the fire sword. I have a shield item right now. I have the fear blink. Oh, I forgot about the fear blink. Wish I had the fire blink though. The fire blink's cooler to show you. There's a lot of items and cool stuff you get. Boss is pretty rad. I like fighting this guy. Oh, see, he turned back into his bigger self pretty fast that time. Okay. big guy again. Oh no, there's two big guys. Oh my god, I've never seen this before. This is crazy. Yeah. Yeah, and she woke up. Yes, yes, you did suggest that. You did suggest that, right? That's right, I remember that, Monkey. I totally remember that. And yeah, that she's got a lot of cool characters. She'll be a sweet, well, I'm almost dead. Oh, died. Oh well, you guys get the point. That's what this game's like. So, okay, I'm going back to making some pixel art for this intro scene. This is gonna be a planet. For one of the scenes. It's Larry. All right, so I'm getting a bit of earth. Ooh, see, that would be really nice. This is cool. What would this look like with this image? This is totally the wrong angle. But it's super cool. I like this. I'm back in podcast mode. Let me see if I can reset it. So I just reset the stream there. Hopefully that fixed the issue. All right, if this was, wait, hold on, let's get rid of this. Oops. I just want to see what this looks like with a sort of like that angle of a planet. You raid hard. Yes. Don't raid soft, raid hard. Always. You guys need like a t-shirt, raiding hard. You could have like another t-shirt, it's like raiding harder. I'm cracking myself up over here. Okay, I think it needs to be a little bit rotated. Some more. I guess it's not quite working. Let's 3D transform this. How many pale fishes? Oh, Jonah, so close! So close! I'm streaming.
I know.
Oh. Alright, let's try squishing this around a bit. Is this helping? I don't know if this is helping. It's probably not helping. This is just the wrong angle. I can't do this. It's the wrong angle. All right, let's play with some other images. I'm getting some inspiration for this planet scene here. This is beautiful. This is kind of what I was imagining right here. Hmm. That's nice. Let's consider that one. Now I might do. All right, Flame, Standish, peace, see ya. Did you see it? This is cool too. That's a lot more like what I was kind of thinking. Wow, this is a really huge quality image there. That's neat too, though. It's really cool. But a little bit more zoomed out than I wanted. Wow. That's awesome. All right, cool. Let's play with some of these. What does that look like? Because that has a sweet atmosphere. All right, let's see. Let's get that sun lined up. I guess it would be cooler if this whole image was its own. Ooh, that's nice. Okay, that's kind of what that one would look like. Oh, the Maxis logo? Yeah, it does, right? What is the Maxis logo again? Oh, right, yeah, they got this little. All right, so what would this look like? This kind of image. I'm just playing around with some other images to just get an idea what this would look like with a totally different concept. Something like this, maybe. None of these are really it, though. That works pretty well, actually. But I was kind of thinking of it being a little darker, so I might play with this a bit. Overworld secret bosses. Oh, that's an idea for the game? Oh, let's put that on the Trello. Overworld secret bosses. Or mobs. I've been thinking of mobs from the same point of view. 'Cause there's a few mobs that you never really get an encounter yet in the game that I would love to have. Like there's a Zerub mob would be sweet. Let me add this here. Or mobs. That's pretty good. I think I'm going to accentuate the edges a bit, though. Start with that. So put this down on the planet for now. So the light's all wrong, gotta fix that and stuff. Let's see what this would look like with only a few colors. The red balls with the giant black floating balls in the middle is like, this thing could be their boss. Oh, the big black floating balls could turn it. Oh, that's an interesting idea. Let's add that to the idea here. Maybe the big black balls can come to life as the red balls is. Red balls is. Boss. The red balls is boss. Say that 25 times fast. Oh, Ragathian, yes. Oh, definitely. They'll be playing with much going on here. I'm getting an overall mock-up image here created. This is really not the detailed art yet. This will be this, I think it's, this is taking longer than I thought, actually. Taking longer than I thought, but oh well. See, what's the only thing that sucks about this reducing the colors is it does it's really sucks out some saturation. Yeah, there's no secret yet. No, there's no secret yet for those big black balls. There's gonna be though. If you have red balls, you should see a doctor. Definitely sounds like a good suggestion. Right? It does. I'm gonna turn off the rim light for now. Cause if I do this blue light, it's gonna need to be. I guess I probably need to do the blue light. Damn. Yeah, I want to keep it blue. Before I do that, let me fill in this coloring here. Yeah, this is Ixera. This is the planet you're on. Yep. I don't think this scene of the intro is going to be animated that much. It'll probably be animated a little. Maybe I'll do a little bit of the sunrise animated, but we'll see. Just kind of playing around right now. I'm trying to get maybe like one scene done per day for the next week or so. So then this intro is kind of cool, you know, with like with maybe around seven scenes or so, it might start looking, you know, more pro, a little bit better. Kind of just it really give you a context for the game. Like you guys that watch the stream, you already know the plot of the game. You already know the characters' names and everything. And a lot of people that are playing the beta kind of know the game a bit already too. But when you're talking about brand new people that have never ever heard of Songbringer, they don't know the character's name and all that kind of stuff. So for their sake, and for everybody else that starts playing this game later on, it needs some kind of context. So that's really what I'm working on right now. Also, the benefit of having a nice context in these intro scenes and everything created is that I can create a dope trailer. I can definitely make the trailer look a lot better than it does right now. Okay, so in general, I want this to be bluish from the blue light of the sun, and then I want to do some lens flare, and then I need to play with the levels a bit too, because I want this to be a little bit less of a sunrise than this image here. Yeah, I use a pen. Some of your jib offs too. Right, so I'm gonna start with the gradient overlay. What's up? What's up, everybody? That's kind of nice, but maybe I'll try some levels first. Ooh, that's kind of cool, actually. Gay Miragi! Can someone give me on point? What? 1 point? Oh, 1 point. Oh, now you got Pedro gave you 2 points? What a dick! I hope I made that even there at the end. What's this at? 104? Yeah, I mean, I could even animate this too. Like, I could do a few frames where it's like it starts off like this. Oh, that is kind of cool. Wow, this could be a sweet sunrise like that, and then the sun can be coming up over it. Yeah, I could do like 3 or 4 frames of this, I think, and make a cool animation. But let's set this somewhere about there. That's really cool seeing a little bit, well, actually maybe a little lower. Yeah, like about like that. Okay, now let's play around with having this bluish light. I see that's too much. That's too much too. That, if anything, and this would be like a multiply light. Oh, multiply light's kind of cool. Hey, what's up, Space? My name. Color burn? Color burn's kind of cool. Screen is too much. Color dodge is kind of neat. See, color dodge, color burn. Yeah, see, color dodge is nicer. Gives it that feeling. Here's multiply. Here's color dodge. Oh, yeah, color dodge. Wow. That gives it that hue. Ooh, that's really nice. That little green there. Amaze, what era is this game gonna be in? Well, technically this is the past for us, but it's a technologically really advanced age. So they have like kind of like Star Wars, almost like Star Wars style technology. So people have spaceships, they have some teleport technology. There's a lot of nanotechnology, which has a lot of rad shit. It's basically like that, you know? That's the era. Okay, I want to do a little sky, a little atmosphere. So I'm going to take this color and make a little atmosphere bubble thing. You render this. Oops, no, don't flatten the image. Merge. Don't know how to do this. We'll just do this. There. Whoops. There. All right. Start over. Start over. There we go. Okay, new layer. There we go. And floating stone elevators. Good point. Good point. Whoops. Woo, woo. Okay, I'm creating a little atmosphere to go behind the planet. There we go. Okay, so now we got this little atmosphere. Let's get a good layer and opacity for it. Let's start with the opacity. So like if it was like, yeah, something really almost transparent like that. We just want the feeling that this has air, is a good pocket of air. Definitely not these darkened and color dodge once again looks pretty cool. Screen. Not screen. Color dodge. Well, they're the same. Overlay. Overlay might be cool if it's just a lot. Interesting. Overlay. Wow, overlay would look pretty cool. Soft light as well. Ooh, I like these. What about hard light? Well, hard light's really too hard. Too hard. Soften the hard. Vivid light. Linear light. Yeah, I'm thinking soft light was pretty cool. Difference, that's weird. Subtraction's also weird. Yeah, look at that. That's nice. And then. What if we didn't have these pixels here? When did you get 500? Right, let's finish the rest of the images. I'm getting too detailed here on this edge. All right, I want something like this sort of lens flare-y thing, but the right color. Let's go for this hue. Let's see what this would look like. Hue, saturation. Saturate to be this color, which is hue 181. Only apply that to that. Whoa, there we go. Ooh, that's cool. Yes, Silton, yes. If you want a Steam key again, you could give it to a friend and you can do whatever you want. A whole new world. What if this was like tilted though? It'd be so much cooler if it was. I need a good lens flare image. It's not really something you can create real fast with pixel art. What the hell? Tab it. Wow. Lens flare inspiration. Lens flares. Look, there's a whole lens flares Photoshop brushes thing. Lens flares are huge. I can't believe I've never used one. This is a totally new experience. Jeez, too many. There's too many flares. It's like, pick one. Pick anyone. Jeez. Can't look at these anymore. Whoa, there are actually transparent pink ones. There are. Oh my god. That's pretty neat. This is a JPEG. This isn't a... Okay, let's put this under the planet. I think I'm just gonna have to make it from scratch. All right, so if I do some straight lines and then blur them, I think I'm gonna get the right effect. What would this look like with little? Yeah, this isn't really. When Rapture comes, I will destroy you all. See, yeah, now this one is still cool. I like this one. Really just works with this image, tell you that. Potfu want a Steam key? Bafu winner! Chicken dinner, man. Good job, Bafu. Okay, I'm just going to use this as inspiration. for now. Merge those layers. Okay, so using that as inspiration, I'm going to start creating some lens flare effects. I need like a squished, oh, I could just do a squished circle. Ah, I got it. I got it. I are delight. Are you trying to get him to talk like the chatbot from Microsoft? I mean, obviously, of course. Better than that. Okay, we need a giant circle, then I'm gonna squish it. Wow, I gotta make the image bigger. Look, it worked. All right, I can like duplicate this little sphere of light here and create some cool lens flare effects out of that. Okay, let's just call that layer lens. And from here, I'm gonna duplicate, work off that. Add a hint of pink? Yeah, good idea. I will. I'll definitely play with the hues here a lot. I just want to get the basic shapes in here first. Maybe I'll make this glow pink or purple or something here. One of these hues that goes. Add the whole rainbow. The whole rainbow. Nothing less will be good enough. Yeah, I like that. It's pretty good. Okay, let's play with this hue a bit. So what if it was pink? What if it was? That's not the one. I want the other one. Ooh, see, that does look pretty cool. Alternate hue for the. This is really nice making it a little bit darker because that darker color is a deeper hue. But look at that. That's. I don't know about. Yeah, pink and red are no. And that blue's a little too deep. But this right about there, that looks pretty good. Also, we could. Okay, that's 31. We could play with the alternate way, which would be going towards green. It's kind of interesting too. Or yellow even, which is yellow looks like it's a little bit too far. Doesn't quite jam with that. All right, let's go back to 31. There, that's a good like sphere of light there to start with. Let's merge those together. And this should be a little, like, let's figure out the right layer to do layer blending type. Definitely not linear burn. Lighten's kind of cool. Screen is sweet. But color dodge is awesome. Wow, color dodge is so cool. Linear dodge, lighter color, overlay, boring. Actually, it is kind of cool. Overlay would be sweet for some of the background layers. Hard light, vivid light. Ooh, whoa, vivid lights. I don't know. I think a vivid light might be the one. Color dodge does make everything retro. Vivid light? Okay, so there's vivid light, there's color dodge. See, vivid light's cool because it does a little bit sharper of an image there, which looks awesome. I'm gonna keep vivid light, I think. Or linear light. No, vivid light for sure. Yeah, vivid light's just got the sweetness. Cool. All right, there's one sphere of light there. If I turn off this background. Get a little bit more. And what if this was on top of the planet? Yeah, it should be on top. Okay. All right, let's do another sphere of light. Actually, should this one be a little bit transparent like this? Maybe like that. 88% is pretty good. $10. 10 pounds. That's it. 10 pounds. All right. So I like this other spear. Well, let's just get another spear. Boogie right, let's do the blur starting with what's this one? 1.5. Kind of looks meh. Do another one. This time we blur like, what was it? We got 1.5 and then. See, I want this to be longer, like a lot longer. But why doesn't this, what in this blur? Blur, damn you. Blur. Now's a good time to start blurring. Anytime you want to do this, Photoshop, what the hell are you doing? What the hell? Oh, look, see that? God damn it. Sometimes it does that. It just selects some random pixels. Yes, we're back in business. About some lens blur. What's up, Red Sands? What about a little more, or maybe some motion blur? Thanks, man. Working on this image here. This is part of the cutscenes for the beginning of the game. I was blurring the wrong layer. No wonder. Screw it. Let's just do this one and that one. This one's got that deeper hue, or maybe a different hue this time. PM, fun fact. And these look so cool with vivid light. Oh wait, if I gotta combine them first. RS stands for room skate. Don't believe him, huh? Ah, there we go. The vivid light ties it all in. And then I need some less opacity. Yeah, there's one. Nice. Another spear that looks pretty good. Spear of light. Just rotate this one. Oh yeah, PMC. I know. I knew you were talking about. I knew you were talking about. Okay, and I'm gonna try experimenting with a different hue. I see this is like a bit too much. And what if this is a different hue? Overall, we rotate that hue. No. It's just looking weird. I was thinking like slightly different, like plus a bit or minus a bit. Whoa, that's kind of cool. Pump that saturation up, and all of a sudden it's got like this, like the light goes further. That's cool. Is there like a threshold where that doesn't work? Looks like it, oh, it's just on the whole time except for if I go to zero, one, two, just boom, it turns on. There we go. Okay. Oh, you know what it's totally missing here in the middle is this the sun itself needs a little bit more blur around it. Well, what happened to the sun? Oh, there it is. Oh wow. People, my people are already on it. All right, there was something this other thing had. Oh, not that one. We can delete that layer. Oh, there it is. Yeah, it's got this like little corona thing going on in the light. Oh, and there's definitely some more brightness there and some more spheres too. But I love that corona thing. I'm gonna do a corona now. I need the edge of a circle. Oh, I did it at 50%. Oh, maybe I'll just keep that. Mutinous, wouldn't it help to get into the habit of naming layers? Does PMC stands for John Cena? No way. Okay, so I'm gonna take this and put it kind of over here to give it sort of this lens flarey effect. Here we go. We'll name this the edge flare. There. I named something. Totally. I name everything almost. Almost everything. Why does that look a little weird? Looks like I rotated it wrong or something. But I didn't. Where's Zilton when you need him? Dude, you name all these layers. This is his favorite thing to do. All right, I'll give this either a deeper hue, or let's actually, yeah, we'll try a deeper hue. Well, nah, yeah. We'll try a deeper hue to start. Or I mean a lighter hue. It's green hue. Pretty cool. All right, starting with that, let's make a flare out of this. Pete, Fred, George, Bob, Sam, all great names. Not just great names, they're great names. Second. I had to make sure I was still on 16 bits again. I had 16-bit OCD right there. Let's do another one, blur it some more. Okay. Merge these together. Oh, wait, before I merge, damn. Yeah. Let's do a little blah, 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 hue shift there. All right, PNC. See you, man. See, the pink and the red are actually kind of interesting. Yeah, let's do some pink. Just like Boogie suggested there about a half an hour ago. And maybe this one actually should be to complement it better. Whoa, crazy. Like chops through. Wow, that's kind of cool. Q104. Some orange compliments? Let's check it out. Ooh, orange is kind of neat too. Wow, actually orange is really cool. And then what was I at 104 over here? That like chops through, and this also chops through a little bit. But in a different way. Yeah, orange looks really good with that pink. I like that. Here's 119. A little too much when it gets to red though. A little too much when it gets more into yellow as well. But right here, like 119-ish. Or right there. That's pretty good. 111. All right, cool. And then this is going to get super dope when we put it all together. First of all, I'm going to merge these. I'm going to unmerge them. Paste in this merge thing I just created. Now we can do vivid light. Whoa, vivid light went crazy that time. Wow, okay, what's soft light? No, new. Color dodge? Interesting. Whoa, the burn is cool. Wow, the burn would be a sweet compliment layer. Calm down there, Photoshop. Huh. Whoa, that is kind of cool actually with the less opacity and then hard light. Color dodge. See the heart, or I mean the vivid light. Vivid light looks cool like that. I'm liking that. So let's do like a black hole effect. This is the edge flare thing. And let's do another layer like it, but let's rotate it. Actually, no, let's not rotate it. Let's just move it outwards and then make it a black hole. Like a black hole like effect where color burns. Oh, it's not doing it out here. Oh, wait, because I didn't have opacity. Yeah, look at that. That's weird, but it's cool. Might be a little bit too much. I like it. I like it actually, but yeah, a little too much. There. Now I can just sort of like barely see it there in the upper image. All right. All right, man. I guess I'll get the image back to how it was. There we go. Now we're back. Now we're doing it. We're doing it for real. This is getting good. This is getting pretty good. I like this image now. Let's do another blur on the sun to get it needs more brightness. It's not like quite like needs yeah. Yeah, it's looking better, huh? Filter. Let's do another Gaussian blur for the sun just to get like, oh. Get not that much. Not that much. About like that. And this can probably go above. Wow, I guess it's ready to put in the game. Let's try this out. I mean, yeah, for a rough draft, this isn't that bad at all. Maybe actually the background white outline perforated circle near the center might help the lens flare effect out. Oh, outline perforated circle. I hear you. I hear you. That's actually a good idea. Yeah. That wasn't in the image that I saw that I started with, the inspiration, but I know what you mean. A nice like little circle would be sweet to see there. Let's do it with this color. But wider. To about, yeah, about like this. Maybe more like that, actually. Yeah. Got 125, so let's go 123. And let's make it gotta make it the right blending and all that. If at least needs to be like around 50%. And now let's play around with some blending to make it look more natural. And then I can like color dodge. There you go. That's pretty cool. Color dodge coming to the rescue once again. Linear dodge, no. Overlay, nah. Soft light. Vivid light, once again, vivid light looks cool too. Yeah, the rest of these are just gonna be weird. Subtract, it's definitely weird. Okay, so we either vivid light, which is pretty awesome, or color dodge, which is exactly the same. All right, vivid light it is. Let's dial in the opacity too, maybe less. Yeah, maybe less. Actually, it's pretty cool. No matter what. Thinking around 50 is pretty good. And then even though that was right in the center of the sun, it doesn't quite look right. It needs to go down a bit. Down and out like that. There. For some reason, that feels more natural to me. Yeah, that did help a lot, Mutinous. Thanks, man. Good suggestion. All right, so if I wanted to, I could even animate this whole thing because of the way the planet starts, its graphics and stuff. But I need to check this in so far. I mean, this is a good document to have already in the code base. So let's add this planet, check it in. There. Now we got a version of it in Git, in the Git repo. So let's put it in the game. Let's put this freaking in the game, man. Oh wait, I wanted to check out this nebula a little bit first. Like if I moved it around a bit or maybe more. Yeah, see? It's kind of cool. With a little bit of nebula. But it needs to go behind the stars. And if there was a nebula on this image, I think it should kind of go over on this side. Whoa, that's cool. Wow, that's really neat. Yeah, I like that. But maybe a little less. Actually, a little more. Yeah. That's pretty good. Nah, what do you think? Don't want this image to get too busy. Kind of busy like that, huh? Maybe it's better to keep it more like this. Just a soft, very soft, slight nebula in the background. Yeah, I like that a little better. Maybe a little, just a little more, but not about, yeah, about there. You're like, the busier, the better. Hook it up with the busyness. Wait, what if it was color dodged? Nope. Color dodge ruined it. Ruined. Yeah, the left side, I could try that too. Okay, let's keep it at normal. I'm gonna try a duplicate image of it on the left as well, because I like the location of this over here on the right. Not flipping. I was trying to get it to flip. Okay, if Yeah, if that is kind of cool too, but if it was a little less, like this one is a little less than that one, so that. Thinking four is a little too much. Yeah, that's pretty good right there. Right about three, just before you really start to notice it. I don't want it to take away from the foreground too much. Okay, this is good enough to try in the game. So save it out. Xera scenes. And let's add it into the texture. Xera. There we go. That's a pretty cool image. I like this. I guess I really should just I should separate out the glowing lens flare effects from the planet, and that way I can animate it. That's what's gonna happen today. I know by the end of today I'll have this thing animated and it will look really cool. It's just gonna happen. I know it, even though I'm not even thinking it. I am thinking it, actually. Separate it for sure, yes, eventually. I'll do that tonight, I think. I want to get it in there right now, and I know that I'm going to need to update the intro layers so it can do more than one graphic. Separate it now, man. Don't hang on, don't wait, don't stretch, don't sleep on the separate, man. Okay, easiest way to see it real quick would be to just comment out this other one and just do Xera as the background and let it fly. So yeah, what I want to do is I want to do both images. So I want to do start with the sun and then you get to the Xera last. So I need to kind of work this scene out so it can do multiple images, kind of cycle through its images. Yeah. Two parts to that. Yes, dude, this is cool. Yeah, making this animated would be super cool. It'd just really add to this whole image. I can see the sun rising in the background just ever so slightly. But I do want to do both images. So I want to see the sun for a minute, and then I want to see this scene for a minute first. Like that's. Yes, Jib. This is the thing. I don't want to really give away too much. I don't want to give away too much. But this is okay. I will give away this much. Jib is writing this story. This is coming from Jib's perspective. So Jib is writing this story. So I think that's about enough. I don't want to give away anything more. I don't want to ruin anything. Hey, Marza! What's up, Marza? How's it going? Ciao, Bella. I mean, Bella Zio. Okay, I'll probably need to mess with that again in a second. Well, let's get both backgrounds now. Chip has a typewriter in his body. It's going good. How's it going? What have you been working on, Marza? What have you been doing? Tell us how the future is. The edge flare could cycle around the sun clockwise as the camera pans upwards. Let me think about that as we let's watch it again. Cycle around the sun clockwise as the camera. Oh, yes. I can see what you're saying. Yeah. As the sun's rising, the flare is moving a bit. Now, that would be interesting. I would have to do several different. Oh, just so after. Well, no, I could probably just rotate it and do some shit. I could probably just rotate it. You're fully employed in the Lanieri project. What's that? Yeah, the flare rotating even just slightly would be super cool. As long as if I did the rotate effect in code, which would probably look a lot smoother, I'll make it so it's actually using the frame buffer, so it actually renders pixel perfect. Oh, right, that site. Nice, you're fully employed. Good for you. Now you too could be a well-dressed man. So here's that background image. I'm thinking, what if I had a stack of images? Or no, what if the first image, I'm trying to simplify this so the code comes out easier and cleaner. Is it Jibs that's making that sound? I was thinking of it more as if you're imagining the, I don't know, some stars, the sound that a star might make. But I don't know. Maybe that is Jib making that sound. Oh, right on. Oh, cool. But that's probably even better, huh? Being freelance. So what if this glow was a child of the first image here? CTO, full stack developer. Right on, man. All right, so I positioned it wrong. Let's position it correctly. Is that supposed to be times one? Oh, you're doing two jobs in one. Mars Power 2016. Are you sure it's 2016? It might be like 2020 for him by now. Oh man, I got the math wrong now. Oh, because it probably need to be half of the image, so. Was it New Year's Eve yesterday? Yeah, man, it was for you. For us, it's like it's 2016. We're having a good time here in the past. And man, the past is awesome, dude. You already know. You already know the past. Hey, that worked. All right, okay, I got it centered, and now it's a child of that other layer. So everything is now cruxed, is like, you know, fulcrumed off of this BG. Right here. So if I change the image for this BG or like remove all its children or whatever. Yeah. Oh, and actually, the layer could be a layer color and it could just be black or whatever color we want. And then I could fade in images, fade in and out. Please make him stop. What am I supposed to make Bafu What's he saying? Ooh, layer gradient. Might even be even cooler. Yeah, let's do it. Layer gradient. It's a child of this. It's color one. So we'll go to just the slightest amount of color, like maybe 8, 8, 8, 8, 255, vector going up, float Z, 0. There. So I'm putting everything as a child of a colored layer now, actually a gradient layer, and then this layer moves. In fact, why is that this code down here? It's a 2-hour warning work. When am I coming to Italy? I know, I do need a vacation, right? You need to look into my future and tell me when I go to Italy. Because I'm ready. All right, so now if I fade out the background, I might be able to fade out the glow layer that's on top of it with it. That'd be too easy. All right, well, I'm looking forward to it, man. I'm looking forward to it. What's up? Wasn't there? Create. Over the course of full fade duration, I want to fade to 0 for this guy. Okay, I'm just testing out if I can fade out the front layer and it will fade both the glow. 1/1/17. Happy New Year! Oh yeah, see, it just faded out the background and not the foreground. All right, well, trying to think of an easy way to just fade everything out without worrying about, wait, can't I just fade the layer? Oh my god, I think I could just fade the layer, duh. Gerben, hello, welcome back, Gerben. See, now it's not working. Damn it. It's not fading that out at all. Oh, because that's the back. Okay, it's the background layer. Of course it wouldn't work. Well, I could use the fade layer I've already got. No, let's make this the fade color. Do this right, const auto fade color. Have you fixed the bugs in the buggy world? Yes, Urban. Yep, the buggy world is all fixed. Those crazy bugs that were, yep, causing that world to just fail for sure. And actually, I've fixed a hell of a lot more. Let me show you a little bit of what's been done recently. Check out all these world seeds. Run without building. Hopefully this runs the overworld. Yeah, okay, so here's some of the world seeds. Not only did I fix the worlds and everything like that, but I improved a lot of the worlds too. So frequently you'll find a save point beyond a section of the overworld now. So the save points are optimal. They're in places where you'd expect to find a good world save point, you know? And also the dungeons are placed a lot more smartly. First of all, the dungeons are never ever placed right next to each other. Secondly, consecutive dungeons are never placed anywhere near each other. And thirdly, the harder dungeons, the more difficult dungeons are placed way deeper in the world now. So the easy dungeons are somewhat close to the beginning. The harder dungeons are are farther away, just like how you would expect if you're playing old school Zelda or whatever. So these worlds have come together quite well in the last. So I had to basically change all the world seeds. So basically, the next time you play the game, your world's going to be totally different. You'll still have all the same items you had, but your world is guaranteed to change. So if anybody is in the middle of a world they're playing Songbringer right now, you probably want to back up the copy of your game. Just back up the whole Songbringer folder. And you can keep playing that old world if you really want to. But otherwise, your world's definitely going to change a little bit. Because everything has been improved with the way overworlds get generated. And not only that, but the retries are way lower too. So it used to have sometimes 30 retries. It would have to create the world. It would find some problem with the world. And it would be like, damn, I can't go on with this world, so it gives up on the world. So now there's almost zero retries, almost all the time, because I just looked at each why it was failing to create the world, and I was like, okay, can I work around that and make the world generator a bit better so it just doesn't fail as much? And yeah, so a lot's improved with the game this week, and there will be an update to Steam by next Wednesday I'm shooting for, which will have this intro scene that I'm working on. This cutscene where it kind of gives you a little bit of the story of the game. Alex Pita, no way. What's up, Alex Pita? Bellazio. All right. So I'm at the point where I'm coding a little bit. I'm almost done with the stream actually, but I'm coding a little bit. So I want to do just one more thing. Where I make it so it does multiple images in this. Happy Easter! Hey, what's up, game? Howdy, you guys. Alright, yeah, so this is fade color now. Yeah, story, totally. Yeah, so the story is kind of going already. Let me show you what they got so far with the story. Actually, so this image is so cool. Let's do this image first. I'm trying to get these two images to go together. So it'll show one for a second, then you do another one. You're happy? Cool. Happy happiness. Happy Easter. Wait, what did I do? What did I do? Oh. So yeah, story is something that has been missing for quite a while. What I was saying earlier is that there's so many people that watch the stream that know a lot of the characters' names of the, you know, people that watch the stream, you all know the names of the characters and you've played the game before. You're aware of the context of the story. You know what I mean? You kind of have a gist of what the story is for Songbringer, but most people don't. Most people who play Songbringer have no clue. So, you know, you got to give some context to the player. So this is going to be a short little intro here, and you can skip it by holding down a key if you want. But yeah, it'll kind of establish some context for the game. So yeah, I'm working on getting multiple images here in these cutscenes. So each image will be really cool, kind of like this, but animated a bit too. Just a little bit of animation. How did I become a mod? You grew up with Rock and Jim over the last year? Is it possible to incorporate bonuses, secrets, and dead end paths? Yes. I saw some paths that branched away from the dungeons in some of those examples. It'd be great if they had a high likelihood for extra fights. Yes, Mutinous. I've been thinking that too. Because a lot of times what I've found is when you go into one of those... Do I get any of those maps? No. When you get into some of those maps, like, it sucks when you get to one of those little dead end paths and there's nothing there. So yeah, I'm gonna make it so there's a higher likelihood of finding secrets there. There's already secrets almost everywhere. There's like tons of secrets littered through the overworld, but it would just be nice to move them so that they're at the ends of those dead end paths. So it's kind of rewarding, and you kind of know how something to expect too. You know the game. I don't know. I'll probably just increase the probability slightly there, so you're not always guaranteed that a reward will be at the end of a dead end path, because then you wouldn't be as surprised. You know, you would know too much. You'd know too much. Teak, what's up? All right, so I'm gonna stream for like about 5 more minutes. I'm just gonna get one image and then another. It's almost like the fade layer needs to run an action. Should I put this as a fade layer action? You know what? Hell, let's just do this a simple way and start. This image, let's do an image count here. Start with scene count 0. Each one of these scenes will have an entry scene count, so we can do a delay, create some stuff. So we'll go this. Run action sequence. Or actually, I want to schedule. Schedule once. And then the delay on this is. I'm thinking how long will each, I guess we'll do total duration. Let's go. Wait, I need a const float. Const float time. Const float scene duration. That's going to be total duration over const int num scenes 2. There's only two of these so far. It's going to be duration over float num scenes. Okay, there we got a scene duration and a scene count. So this starts with the background. This background. And it fades out. Wait. We need to schedule this so it fades out later. Damn. Hold on, do I have an enims fade? Dude, everything's broken. Broken! Fade. Do we ease from opacity? No, I wanted a delay. This is just going to get complicated, though. If I do it this way, where I make every single scene fade out and then fade back in, there's got to be a simpler way, man. BG. Dude, what's up? Autocomplete just stopped working again. A line count, huh? Line count. What do we got for a line count? 53,000 lines of code. Good Lord. That's getting up there. What are the biggest culprits here? Title scene's pretty big. Kit's huge. Flux is even bigger. Damn, 4,000. Same as area. 4,000 lines of code. And you can tell I'm trying to keep it all split up into the right systems and components and all that, but shit. Sometimes you just get a function or a file that's 4,000 lines long. Yeah, it's getting there, right? Songbringer's turning into a big game. There. This is just a simple action. It deletes itself after a minute. Do the same thing with the glow. And I'll get, oh, this could just be an auto ref because I'm doing a delay. And Glow, run action, same thing, scene duration. Oh, this is scene duration times scene count. All right, and then after this, we would do another one. So here's scene one. How CPU intensive is the game? I want to pre-order, but I don't know if it'll run on my computer. What are the mins? You know, I don't have some very good accurate minimum requirements yet, but it should run on some pretty old hardware just fine. And there are, Urban, there are some optimization things you can do too. It's not that CPU intensive. It's really more GPU intensive than anything. It uses shaders and all that. But you can disable a lot of things to make it faster, right? There's this no fog setting. There's a no blur setting and a no reflection setting. And eventually I'll make these into like one setting on the settings menu. But anyways, it's a pretty simple game. It's a pixel art game, so it's not that intensive. It shouldn't be that intensive on your CPU or anything. Hell, it can even run on an Apple. What's up, Marangia? All right, here's scene two. All right, I just want this thing to fade in and out. So this time we're going to delay scene duration. Time scene count. Minus one. But no minus fade duration. And then we're going to fade this in. Then we delay a further scene duration minus fade duration. And then fade out, remove self. Okay, let's give this a shot. All right, Urban, cool, man. And you can also get it for free if you just watch enough of the stream and then raffle your points. Okay, I did mess something up. What happened? How could glow pointer be bad? This glow pointer, it's got a good sprite. Oh. Oh. This is supposed to be scene count plus one. Yame, did I contact the press yet? Oh yeah, I've contacted the press a lot. The game's already been featured, oh shit, it kept the other. We got two images here on one screen. But yeah, the game's already been, got a lot of press. You can see the press that Sombringer's got on Sombringer.com. There's a few of these quotes from Kotaku, Taku, Eurogamer, Clickus. These are some of the best ones. And then there's also another, there's a whole press kit too. So if you want to look at the press sheet, it's just wizardfoo.com/press. And that'll get you into this press sheet thing. And yep, there's a lot of quotes. There's more quotes than that. There's quotes from like Pocket Gamer and Indie Root and all that. Yeah. And I'll need to contact the press a lot more when I start getting into the end of the game phase and when I'm releasing it and all that. So for some reason, the second scene came in right away. This is where it's getting complicated. I need to rip Fubot. Thanks, Gabe. Thanks for saying that. I hope it's a hint, it's an indie hit. I really do. I'm just going to keep making it as awesome as I possibly can and not really, you know, to worry too much about how it will turn out as far as the press is concerned or whatever, you know. I just want to make a cool game that's fun for people to play. Okay, if I get rid of this, let's see if the first part works. You want a steak? I want a steak too. I'm hungry. I gotta stop streaming because it's already been 2.5 hours. Okay, so if this works, we should see half of this scene and then it will fade out the star. There it goes. Oh, but it didn't really fade the glow part very well. Oh well. All right, that's gonna be it for today's stream. I gotta get some food in my belly. Some food time. Wizard food. Food time. Wizard food. Wizard needs some wizard food. Okay, so yeah, that's it for today's stream, guys. Thanks for everybody for dropping by. It's been you see some people that I haven't seen in a while. Hope you guys are all doing good, and thanks for watching, and thanks always for your support with this game. I really appreciate all y'all's support, financially, suggestions-wise, your emotional encouragement support. So really, I really appreciate you all. Have a good one. We'll see you next time.